I'm going to forcibly read this quite quickly because...
Do you want to identify yourself?
Oh, hello. Yeah, my name is Tim Leffman. I live in Fairfield Way and I can see the stadium from my front room.
Thank you.
I found myself a little bit. I've got 3 minutes, yes?
Yes.
Please forgive me for speaking quickly. There's a lot to say. Can I go?
Yes.
3, 2, 1. 463 people against 36 sat down and wrote to the council to object to this. On the following grounds: safety, congestion, the green belt, and a half-empty school 500 yards away. There were 3 serious accidents in November, December of last year. There will be 1,800 people aged 11 and upwards from 2 rival schools, one disgruntled, running, jumping, play, fighting, like normal kids converging on this mind-bogglingly busy junction. They will be breathing illegal levels of pollution. In Underhill, 7 sites were tested by Friends of the Earth, 5 are dangerous, of which 3 are already illegal. I have the figures right here. The increase in traffic will make it substantially worse, especially if you widen a small section of road and double the number of cars standing still. Congestion. It's going to bring Underhill to gridlock. It's going to block Barnet from all directions. A1 and 411 commuters will have to divert to St Albans Road. They'll clog the high street. Our pioneer will be the foot on the front of 2 of these roads, blocking the rest of Barnet. Utter chaos is already regular and frequent without our pioneers, 1,500 extra students, staff and parents. And don't forget, up till now, very few people stop on that roundabout. These people will all be stopping and escorting children. Parking. Read the change.org website article about John Keats School when it was only 1/3 full. We are very concerned about standard of driving, poor choices in parking. We witness every morning and every afternoon parking illegally on yellow lines, including zigzag lines, leaving their cars unattended, blocking the road with engines running. Your travel plan envisages Burnt Open Edgeware students getting off the already jammed 251 at Totteridge and walking 2 kilometres each way every day, rain or shine, page 9, paragraph 5.11 of your travel plans. Really? Wait for the winter. Okay, 62 parking spaces for nearly 200 staff, including caterers everywhere. It will mean cars will park all the way down Fairfield Way and kettle us in. At the moment, if there are cars on both sides, only one car can go in either direction. God forbid you have a house fire or a heart attack during school hours, you will receive no help from them. Greenbelt, you can't build on a greenbelt without a good reason. This is not a good reason. If you're determined to build on the greenbelt, like you seem to be, do it at TTA. Don't do it there. Conclusion. Fix TTA. It's a resurgent school with a passionate, enthusiastic body of staff and students who just recorded their best ever GCSE results. They also have almost 500 empty places. We don't need an art school 500 yards away where TTA is led by an outstanding teacher steeped in their principles, Chris Fairhair. Where's the brain for choice? Put your energies into refuting ignorance, prejudice and misinformation about TTA, support them in their efforts, which are showing fruit. Underhill, our pioneer, will put all their good work at risk for what? A polluted, gridlocked, unsafe and wholly unwelcome proposal that will guarantee misery to Underhill residents, the surrounding wards and through traffic for decades to come.
Thank you, Chairman. If, as you've indicated, others indicated, the demand for places at the so-called Art Pioneer is nothing like as intense and dense as been mooted by the officers, that's going to cause people to travel in from the west of the borough. That's going to be extra traffic on Barnet Lane, Totteridge Lane to start with, and Maze Lane. Is there any more room for more traffic that is not already planned for coming down those roads?
I think they've already told us that the junction at Underhill is at capacity, and all the traffic comes from Maze Lane, Barnet Lane, Totteridge Lane, Barnet Lane, which are ordinary A roads. There's no provision for widening them. Barnet Lane and Barnet Gate Lane have particularly nasty little bends in the middle of narrowing parts. The traffic's already appalling. When there are cars stopping, the children off and kiss them goodbye and get the family out of the back and keep the dog in the car, they are going to be, it's just, you have no idea. Right now, you can only get one car in either direction on West Coast Drive if there's a car park there. Cool. So in Fairfield Way the same, you can only get one car coming either north or south. And those passing places will all be full.
And no escape routes. There are no other roads out there.
No, there are hundreds of houses down Fairfield Way, Westcombe Drive, Western Way, Grassmere Avenue, Sherrod's Way, hundreds and hundreds of homes down there, all kettled by the cars parked on the street on both sides. Where one car can go this way, or you can let the other car go that way, that cars cannot pass on.
Any more questions, Councillor Francis?
I do have a further question.
Sorry?
I do have a further question, Chair.
Quickly.
Of course, quickly. I'm concerned, I'm sure others are, that based upon the figures that we've heard this evening, that Tottenham Academy is going to face further underpopulation from students. Is this proposed development not going to put actual pressure on a school that is now showing itself to be very successful? Is this really going to help the education in the borough or not?
Well, it's not going to help that education in the borough because obviously a lot of people don't want to send their children to TTA because there's a lot of misconceptions, there's prior prejudice, there's a lot of ignorance about how well they're doing there now. But if you speak to the children there, speak to the staff there, and you have any idea about the caliber of the leader of TTA, it's an excellent school which you should be thinking very seriously about for your children and improving. If art comes in,
There's
a proposal to put in a 90th place special school with children with special needs, something very close to my heart. I know that exists. I would be very happy with the sports. Obviously, I'd be happy with the sports centre. It's not fair to say that, but
a sports centre would bring more parking. People come to the sports centre, and a special school would require more vehicles coming, and specialised vehicles coming to that school.
I believe that a 90 place school would have a considerably smaller footprint than a school for 1,300 people.
Just as a side, not a planning reason. My grandson goes to Tottenham Academy, and I could tell you some tales about that.
Maybe
Councillor Paul Edwards, you did ask me to speak, and if you'd like to speak, please come forward.
Exactly, conflict of interest over there.
Why is that a conflict of interest?
And she doesn't like Tottenham Academy.
It's her grandson.
Yeah, her grandson.
Is that a conflict of interest?
I'd say so.
You have spoken.
No, I was just talking.
We are not looking at Tottenham Academy for planning, so it is not a conflict of interest.
Really?
She's looking at it. Yes. Thank you. Thank you.